Welcome back to the NutriMedical Report. And yes, there's a lot of dense information here, but you need to understand the summary. What Alexander Bachman is saying, I'd like to hear a quick reflex response from Dr. H. Ruat. And then we're going to get into some of the esoterica with Freeman, as well as Alexander and Dr. Ott, because this is science, but also there's some esoterica, there's some ceremony, there's sacred geometry, there's numerology of dates and places. This is all by design, and that's why they launched this virus in North America. They literally launched it in the Aztec country of Mexico because they're getting ready for the 2012 return of Quetzalcoatl, and in fact, the name of America means the land of the feathered serpent god. So let's complete this thought with a comment by Dr. H. Ruat in terms of what he sees, and then some further comments by Alexander Bachman, and then we're going to get into the esoterica this hour and next.
Well, yes, Dr. Bill and Mike, and kudos to Alexander. He's putting the timelines together very well. I've been saying the same thing. Watch out, watch out, watch out.
Don't put your guard down. Dr. Chan is telling the truth, in other words, when she's telling you this is not going away. And everybody says, oh, breathe a sigh of relief. It's a hoax, and they're listening to all these people that are non-scientists. Listen, people. This is a slow-moving thing, and as it acquires new genetics, it comes back with a vengeance.
Well, I would just remind everybody, and again, go and do your own study and do your own research. Find out what Barack Obama did in 2005, just after he took his Senate seat.
Well,
find out how heavily he was invested in biofirm research.
AVIR, which works with Baxter, and Baxter is
right.
The one that has a contract for the that was just given by Obama, the contract. Baxter AVIR was just given the contract, which he still has shares in, to supply the new H1N1 flu virus vaccine, which will be available in October this year for this current, quote, pandemic. He's actually authorized it, so now in 6 months, they'll have the vaccine and they'll be ready for their, quote, martial law drills to go up the next notch.
Exactly. Go back and read and review the speeches he gave as a freshman senator. He did nothing but spout about the coming pandemic. He talked about it breaking out in South America and Mexico. Go read it. You bet, Alexander. You're darn right. There's something very fishy going on there.
Yeah.
Especially with the big new Brzezinski pulling his chain. Brzezinski, I would refer you back, is a co-author with Henry Kissinger and the rest of that wild bunch, talking about specific areas of the country needing to be depopulated. Go back and read the record.
And guess who the main funder, and I put this up on the 30th, the main funder and owner of Novavax Corporation is none other than Soros Biopharmaceutical Inc. Mr. Soros, the inventor of the structured investment vehicle, the derivative, Mr. Evil himself that sold the goods of Jews heading to the death camps in the Second World War, Mr. Soros without conscience, the right-hand man of the Rothschilds, is out there literally funding the bioweapon companies that are actually creating the next pandemic flu, and guaranteed, now they got this cover, whether it's this virus or another weaponized virus that'll be released, they're getting ready to do it in the next few months because
and
they need
also,
a cover.
Yes, also, go look at who Taubenberger was answering to. Jeffrey Taubenberger at Fort Detrick, he was referring constantly and giving reports every quarter to a group of AIPAC funders, which you follow the trail, follow the thread,
right.
And Dr. Henry Kissinger is right at the forefront.
Exactly. Amazing.
You know, this is genocide, folks.
Yeah, it is genocide. And that's why, by the way, and I'm not going to say how it happened, but there were threats not, and I'm not going to say who it was to, but there were threats to cease and desist, not to have further discussions or discussions about Len Horowitz's work. Well, I went further, and those articles are posted there, including the names of Dr. Robertson, Dr. Bright, and others that went back and forth between the CDC and Novavax Corporation that's based in Pennsylvania and in the UK, the NIBSC, the EMEA organization in Europe that maintains and monitors all these things. It's involved with the trading of the viruses. They come from Baxter EVIR, again, tied directly back to the junior senator and now president, I call him the usurper-in-chief, literally signing over to say, hey, don't worry, we'll save you with the future vaccine. If you take any vaccine in the future, you are literally screwed. And people need to understand this, what's coming. They're getting ready, and they may, and they're vaccinating our troops now. They're getting ready to vaccinate the county sheriffs, and they just want to have enough fear to make people take the next step that maybe God knows what it'll release if they start vaccinating, mass vaccination of the people.
Well, like Dr. McBean swore before Congress in 1976, 1977, if you turn the clock back and remember that swine flu pandemic fear and threat that was back in the 70s, Dr. McBean flat out basically stopped that from happening because she showed that it had to be a problem reaction solution scenario, and she fingered the specific big pharma companies that were poised to reap billions at the expense of millions of dead people back in the 70s.
Right, and although some people quote it was 25 dead, what I've heard is that over 200 dead from the swine flu vaccine, that's the numbers I have from my medical colleagues, that means that more people died of the vaccine than died of, quote, the swine flu. And people need to understand this was a vaccine based on them still having vials of the 1918 flu around.
Yes, okay? So here you have all these new human kidney cell-based vaccines that are poised to come from China via our friend Dr. Kissinger and others to come and have every man, woman, and child injected with something like this.
Yeah.
Not tested, tried, not true, not proven.
Absolutely. Let's get into some of the esoterica now. I want to start with Freeman because he has the deepest understanding of this issue. Freeman, when you see all these events, and you see the science, and you see the locations and the timelines that we're working with Alexander Bachman, who's building this timeline, who's in Mexico, who's visited Mexico City, who's tried to get information out, and the truth isn't coming out that there's a second strain on its way. What do you see? And then I want to hear Alexander Bachman, who also has some esoteric understanding of Dr. H. Watt. What do you see happening, Freeman?
Well, they're definitely trying to spread the fear. There's no doubt about that.
Oh, yeah, that's the Kool-Aid of the New World Order. They have to spread the fear, and it's part of the Reichian mind control to split the people's minds. Send them a message, oh, be fearful, be very fearful. Oh, don't worry about it, it's nothing. It's a hoax, it's nothing going on. And you send both messages, and the person to cope with it, their mind has to split. They get a cognitive dissonance. They can't then respond properly to get food, to get prepared with biomasks and other things for something that is coming, and when a more lethal strain comes, then, of course, people will fall right into the hands of the government that says, yeah, just show up for your vaccines and your food and you'll be fine in civil detention camps. This is their game. They're playing it to get the people paralyzed by sending a double message.
Absolutely. You can find, right at the early pre-programming was with Hall's commercials when they were showing people coughing in a restaurant or on a bus. And then the other people in the restaurant were starting to grab weapons to come kill these people, and that was their advertisement for Halls. This was out, probably about 2005 they started that campaign.
Whoa, that's pretty serious commercial.
It was. It was scary. It really was. You know, they're showing a Japanese chef with a butcher coming after a coughing man.
Yeah.
This was, predictive programming.
Yeah, and then he cuts the Hall's, set of Hall's mints together and gives him one on the end of the knife. I saw that commercial.
Exactly. And then we've got this strange story of the Felipe Solis dying, some report 12 hours after meeting Obama in Mexico. Of the swine flu, but then the next very same story says that he died on the 23rd, a week later, of pre-existing pneumonia causes. And so
garbage. Come on, they don't know something's up. Something's going on here. It stinks of high heaven, and we know that they've got something planned because one of their ceremonies is they'll tell you in advance they're going to do it, and the people, sheeple, don't believe it. They think, oh, it's a hoax. It's not a hoax, people. This first wave is predictive programming. It's to shatter your ability to get ready by telling you, oh, see, it's no big deal. Your kids went home for a week from school. It's not going to harm you. It's not going to shut down the world. They're getting ready, people. The big bad ones are coming. And if you don't get ready, you're going to be in a state of shock. If you don't get your guns, your ammo, your food, things are going to happen. This summer and fall, the waves are going to increase, and it's not going away. We'll be back in a moment with more with Freeman, Alexander Bachman, and Dr. H. Watt. Hour 3 coming up. We're going to be joined by John Spring.